So the pips on the backhand of Han Ying are short pips, which means she can attack with them. And this is what you'll see a lot against defense. Typically, the amount of underspin that Han Ying will put on the ball. It's going to be quite varied, but that was a nice side spin there as well.
Yeah. And so sometimes disguised with the after motion just to kind of discombobulate the opponent. Add a bit of disorientation.
That's actually the word that she used when I said, what's your strategy? She's like, I want to discombobulate her.
Lap three.
Maybe she would say that in German or in Chinese, yeah,
imagine,
Han Ying.
Imagine that in a German accent. That would be something, eh?
Try to get it later at dinner. We'll see. So a good start here for Han Ying, Lily Zhang with the uphill battle. This is a tough way to win a point. One. Three attacks in a row.
And what she's showing here is that she has the physicality to come over the ball and come through it. But the question is, can she read it? I see her struggling more with the touch play than the opening up, actually, and the push play, because obviously the more you attack, sometimes the heavier it can get.
Yeah, typically against defenders, players are told attack one, then bring them back in. Like this, for example, patient play, but the final opening backhand finds the net. As I was touching on with the short pips, though, there's greater control. So not only can you attack with them, but you can really empty the spin. As opposed to if you're using traditional long pips as a chopper, you basically are giving back what comes in. You don't have as much control of the spin. Nice empty serve.
Yeah, that was nice. I think as well, Han Ying isn't a chopper that goes so far back, so you don't have so much time even though she's a chopper.
It always is a fine balance, that sort of patience, yet recognizing the opportunity. Lily Zhang knows this well. And while it hasn't worked out for her, you saw her percentages against defenders. She's capable.
Pressuring that one. That's one that she should make probably 8 times out of 10 at least. Because it can be frustrating as an attacker because you feel obliged to attack.
Smart play here. Gets Han Ying to bring in some good old-fashioned familiar topspin, and Lily cracks through it for the win.
It's another thing about Han Ying, isn't it? Even more pressure to make good quality attacks and pushes because she can come in with those sweeping ones. She sometimes even fades into the middle, I've noticed.
Devastating that you should have to worry about someone with the backhand just punching it like that in near the net. She's dangerous, Han Ying.
And what you've seen of Han Ying, I mean, is it easier to punch with the short pips than it is with the long pips coming into a ball like that?
100%. It's one of the advertised benefits of short pips. I mean, if you think back to other choppers, Hitomi Sato, of just a handful recently that have been at the top of the game or top 10 in the world, had to twiddle the racket, meaning turning it around 180 degrees to attack with the backhand. But Han Ying doesn't. She's always in position and ready with the grip of the racket.
Ten, three.
So 7 game points here for Germany's Europe top 16 winner, Han Ying. The crushing forehand does it. The serve sets it up. Lily Zhang used to play in the United States. That's how they know each other.
Oh, beautiful counter.
Lap one.
Yeah, tough to tell where she was going to go there. Went on the parallel down the middle of the table. Lily Zhang was set up in the forehand and had to quickly backtrack.
I think what it is about Han Ying's counter is she's not taking it early and over the top. She's letting it drop a little bit, but then playing it with a more open racket face.
Yeah, she's quite versatile in that way. It depends on the shot, but she can do both very effectively. even in the counter topspin rally here, this is how strong and well-prepared Han Ying is.
When are you ever safe, Adam? When are you ever safe?
And that's actually what I was just thinking. When you're on Lily Zhang's side, you think about what tactics do you have against a defender? Can you play the push? 13 of the last 16 points before this. One in the right direction for Lily Zhang. But there are players who will push back and forth, meaning play slow defensive shots with the chopper to send it into the expedite rule and force the defender to attack.
1-4.
But it still would take, one, a much closer score line, two, much longer rallies, and three, Han Ying's just too good on the attack to allow herself to be handcuffed or trapped, forced into that expedite game.
Lily seems to play on her haunches a little bit more than a lot of attackers. She seems to be quite upright when she plays her pushes sometimes and flicks, I've noticed.
Haunches, huh?
Yeah. With some players, you know, they're really forward over the ball. Lily's quite, she's bending her legs, but she's quite upright, I've noticed.
Five, two.
I think Han Ying does an excellent job of moving the ball around on the table here. In general, Lily Zhang has quite a strong base. I mean, you can see she's very fit, tends to stay quite low, wide feet, you know, stance.
Two, six.
It's one of the toughest things in the world. Just keeping the ball out of the net, attacking against these heavy chops. So much rotation on that. That's the inverted rubber, the forehand of Han Ying, that loads that ball with spin. Power shot this time around. The perfect read goes down the middle of the table, a little bit shorter side. It finishes clearly.
Far better shot selection. It was high enough to come through flat. Much more like it, right?
Four.
It's tricky. It's not easy to get Han Ying to play the ball off the table into the net, especially in the push game. But Lily Zhang with a much more convincing scoreline now. Ooh, sets it up well with
seven,
the flick.
Four.
Gets Han Ying way behind the table. The start of this point was perfectly constructed. The risks had paid off.
But then that first one's more floaty than I think Lily Zhang thought it was there. First chop. Oh.
4-8.
The second towel break here, and despite a nice string of points there for a bit, it's Han Ying who's taking control once again, right near that edge of the table. Only needs to touch the playing surface.
4-9.
That is so tough to lift when it's that close to the baseline for a second bounce. Han Ying, much like a serve, keeping it half long. This makes it really tough. If the push rallies aren't working out for you, the attack rallies are working in favor of your opponent. Han Ying in an outstanding position with six game points here.
10-5.
Took her chances.
Yeah. Good job it was shallow on the table.
Right, Lily with a nice touch there on the receive. And
11,
that's what the
five.
Short pips can do. That quick back.
One love.
In terms of the variation of spin, it's not just the attacking game. It's the touch game, as you can see, that Han Ying is constantly changing it. Makes it so tough.
That is so backspinny. I mean, if there's any doubt in Lily Zhang's mind, probably better to try and touch that one, because Han Ying was so far away from the table there. Still not easy to play it.
So you can see how effective the serves have been for Han Ying. Lily Zhang with about a third of her points won on serve. But in all fairness, if you look at her points won period,
time
as
out.
She goes into a timeout, her coach in the corner.
For love.
But born and raised in California, native English speaker. Han Ying, right out of the timeout, gets the next point.
4-1.
Looked like Lily was waiting to go around the net on that one. Yeah. Had it come wide enough.
Mm. 2-4.
Trying to disrupt the rhythm of Han Yin could be good. And a good tactic against someone like Han is to go into the body initially in the first attack.
Right. It's funny, a lot of people forget it's such a tactical game playing against defenders because it's just a very different set of tactics you would use. Nice setup here, and it takes two. But the tactics similarly, as you mentioned, yes, the crossover point is still going to be a place where players are less comfortable. Lily with that powerful backhand still has to play one more. Looks like it might have gone over the barriers, that inside-out smash.
Oh, some great backhands played there.
Yeah, she has a very strong backhand, Lily Zhang, but as they talked about in the corner, you could hear her and Coach Liang talking about the rotation, the spin, and control.
Yeah, this is so much better now. She's not snatching too much at it, and even when it's a high ball, she's still coming up the back of it, even though she's transferring the energy forwards. Against the kind of player like Han Ying that you can't afford to be too square to the table when you play your forehands. As a right-hander, you want your left leg in front of your right so you can transfer through. Can't do that if you're square. You'll lose balance.
Not an easy ball to play, but Lily Zhang powers through and reads it just right for that flat kill shot.
This timeout's done wonders.
It's interesting. Yeah, she didn't get the first point out of the timeout, but since then, quite a turnaround. And look at the scoreboard now. 6 of the last 8 points for Lily Zhang. Patience, the cautious play from Lily Zhang. I think she had learned quickly from trying to attack a few in a row that sat up a little bit higher, that felt like they should be reasonable to just kill, but then it was the push in the end. When you think about it, a chopper is used to playing an attacker, so a defender plays a lot more attackers than attackers play defenders. Han Ying to save that above head height. She returns it with interest with topspin on it.
She knows exactly where the ball's going to go and exactly what trajectory the ball's going to have once it hits her side of the table. That is amazing.
Kill shot, that sound, that high pitch of the slap, less spin, and Han Ying. 2 points
maybe
in front, last
match,
3 in a row.
We can go back to hotel. Because after this match, we have time. We can go back. Yeah.
The reason I brought up that defenders play attackers more than the other way around is the longer the match goes on, the more adapting we'll see on Lily's side. Oh, clever idea. Tries to leave it short, but Han Ying close enough to the table that the threat's still there.
No, I like that, because if that comes on, Han Ying's going to have to rush into the table and won't be able to make as quality of a shot. Unfortunate for Lily Zhang there.
And now it is 4 game and match points for Han Ying to move on to the round of 16 in the women's singles event.
Xin Yubin awaits the winner.
Ooh, should be interesting. Doesn't miss by a lot. Lily Zhang is right there to move to the wide forehand just in case. One match point saved. Still 3 more for the world's top defender, Han Ying. what a point to finish on Lily Zhang with a chop in the push and a good smile, but a tough opponent. It is Han Yu.